Thanks for watching this video. This is a short little video that I put together last minute. I was doing a craft pot project in my craft room and I thought, wow, this is something that I think people would like to see. So it's not gonna be the best quality. I didn't set up my camera for that, but now I did buy a better tripod so that I can bring you some kind of crafting type of videos. So stay tuned for that. This is not a crafting channel, but it's part of who I am and in my life. And when I'm not traveling in my RV, it's a way for me to express what God has made me to be and what I enjoy to do, which is doing crafts and beautifying things and my environment and my life and my home. So stay tuned for that. I'm gonna bring you this little video now. So if you follow me on the RV channel, you're not gonna see these kind of things over there. You're only gonna see them on this channel. So thanks for watching, and now here's the video. I bought these notebooks at Hobby Lobby. You get three of them for $7.99, and I really bought them for notebooks, but I just love the cover so much and I want to put them in a picture frame. So what I did was, on this one, because it's sewn in, all I did was cut the threading and took out the notebook, the actual notebook, which is really simple to do. I'll show you with this one. All you're going to do is going to separate it here, and you're just going to cut that little piece of threading, and then you can separate the notebook and then you have the cover. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use these, because it's this nice thick cardboard. I love it. And I just love this so much. I'm gonna cover some picture frames that I have, and this is going to be inside my picture frames. So right now I'm doing that, and then I'll come back and I'll show you that. This is what I got. I have this picture frame, and I had this picture in my room, and I don't want this anymore. So I took it apart. And so what I'm doing is I'm turning it around so that the back side I'm gonna cover with this bulletin board paper that I had, that I used for another project I have left over. So I'm going to glue this here. This is going to be my backdrop, and then I'm going to cut this, and then this is going to go here, and then that's going to go in the picture frame. So this is that notebook, but I'm going to end up cutting it here so that it fits in the middle, and then I'll have this piece left over. I guess I could use for some other project sometime. I'm going to glue the paper to the back side of this picture in case I ever do want to use this picture again. I can always just turn it around. Right, so far it's looking good. So what I did was I took my distress ink here and I just went over the edge of it a little bit, because it was like super white around the edges and didn't look good. So I thought it needs a little interest. So I did cut a piece off of the notebook because the notebook was rounded corner here. So I just wanted to make it even with the other side. So now I'm going to attach it there, and then I'm going to finish that off. So this is my beautiful print. This is what I did. You see the cover? This is the cover of that notebook that I cut up. And what I did was I put some distress ink, because then it looks too white. So as you can see, the background paper is the same as the front paper. And I have a big roll of that. So I put it going up and down. And then, because I want it to stand out from this to stand out from the back. So I put it facing up. The wood look pieces, and then because this one goes sideways. So I love that one, and I used to have the animal print there, but I didn't want that there anymore. So I think that's really pretty. And on the other side of my bed, I put this one, which I like a lot as well. This is from the other notebook. In the video that you just saw, I wanted to show you the notebooks that I'm using, which are the notebooks I got them from Hobby Lobby. Now, I showed you that I had this portfolio that I was using as a planner, and this is an A5 size, and I'll link it below. This is my planner now. I was using this as a planner, but when I traveled, this was just too big for me. So this is an A5 size, and this is a B6 size. And you can see the difference in the size. I mean, for most people, it doesn't matter, but when you travel, it makes a huge difference. This is what I do all of my planning with. I decided to use this as my war binder, I guess you could say, is what people call it. So I do my Bible studies in here, and I already did a video on that, but I'm going to do an updated video in February because I'm changing things a little bit in here. But I did want to show you the notebooks that you saw in the video were the same as these, except these are different covers. So these come in a pack of three for $7.99 at Hobby Lobby. So I got this one. This one came with this set. So
There you go. These make great gifts. You want to frame them. You can cut it out and you can make a beautiful frame for your friends with that. So as you can see, I have two more that I haven't used yet. So eventually I will go into these. I also wanted to show you, once I took the paper out, I ended up with this. You could see this is still, it's sewn here in the middle. So it did, when once you cut the cover off of it, it's still intact. So what I ended up using is I cut it down to size for my B6. So now I have a notebook in here that I made for my B6 planner. I have two notebooks actually that I made. I put scrapbook paper, I made one here, and then I have another one, another notebook in here. And I can show you my planner in another video if you want to see it and what I put in, what I use for that for. This you can still use. This is the inside of it. So it's really cheap and economical because you get three notebooks for $7.99. So you can do three gifts with those three notebooks and you're still going to have the paper available for you to take notes.
I almost forgot to show you that the two backings that I got cut off, I made a notebook with that. So this, if you look, this would be the backing of one notebook and this is the backing for the other notebook. So what I did was I put them together and I put some washi tape, and washi tapes, you can get them in all kinds of colors, decorations. So I just sealed it up with some washi tape and I put a rubber band here because that way the notebook is a little bit more sturdier. It's just a regular like Midori kind of traveler's notebook rubber band. You can get them on Amazon. And then I put some Happy Planner stickers here. So this is really upside down because it's really this way, but I thought it was okay if I did it like that. So this is the front of my notebook. I put Happy Planner sticker, Happy Planner sticker there. And that's my notebook.
Hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and stay tuned. I've got more crafts video every month on this channel. And we'll see where we go from there. Thanks for watching. Bye.